Welcome to Oracle's CX Marketing Help Center videos. In this video, you'll learn how apps are used in Responsys programs. Let's start by designing our Responsys program. We'll make the entry points to our program a customer activated and customer deactivated event. Next, we want our contacts to flow into our app stage, and then the program will end. The app stage works just like any other Responsys program stage you normally use for cross-channel orchestration. Contacts will enter the app stage and Responsys will push these contacts to the app. The app, based on its action, will perform the specified action on the contacts it receives from Responsys. Apps can have the contacts or enactments from Responsys profile lists, profile extension tables, and other tables in form of ETVs. Here we are using the start stage as customer activated, which is an example of a triggered case where an enactment enters the app stage when activated. The start stage can also be a batch stage, like a schedule filter, wherein the app stage will receive enactments in bulk. The app we will be demonstrating today is called the Churnout Likeliness app. The purpose of our app is to determine the likelihood that a customer will churn out. When you drag and drop an app stage onto a program canvas and choose a service, it creates an instance of the service. Next, for the data coming into the app, we need to define a program ETV so that Responsys can map this incoming data to a field that Responsys knows. Navigate to Settings, Tracking and Variables. The fields from Profile Lists and Profile Extension Tables can be directly pushed. The other table fields need to be mapped as ETVs. Let's call our ETV Churn ETV, and the type will be text. Now let's configure the service. Clicking Configure App will open the service's configuration user interface. Responsys provides the iframe for displaying its configuration, and the app displays the actual HTML content that displays here to configure the service instance. Every app will be different, but in our case, the churnout calculator will calculate the likelihood a customer will churn out and store this information in the ETB we created earlier called Churn ETB. Let's save the configuration. This sends our configurations to the app, and the app saves it on the app's end for the particular service instance. Next, we'll close the window. Next, we'll validate our program, and when that's done, we're ready to publish. Click Publish. Our program published was successful. When it's time to analyze the program, verify that enactments are flowing through your app to verify everything is working as expected. Thank you for watching. For more information, see the links in the video description.